The Three Little Procurers. Once upon a time, there were three little procurers, and the time came for them to leave home and seek their fortunes. Before they left, their mother told them,
"Whatever you do, do it as best you can, because that's the way to get along in the world, and also be aware of the big bad wolf."
The three little procurers took off into the wild, and soon they realized that the need for shelter and protection was imminent. The first little procurer built his shelter out of cheap straw that he quickly procured from the market. Little did the first little procurer know that the shelter made out of straw had very little chance to outlive even the high winds of the autumn storms in Procureland. The second little procurer procured his entire shelter from a well-known local construction company, since their bid was way cheaper than that of the other bidders from the market. Little did the second little procurer know that the construction company was well known for hiring low-quality subcontractors to build shelters out of brittle sticks. The shelter came out a little bit stronger than the straw one, but it was not built for the cold and dark winters of the Procureland. The third little procurer was well aware of the dark and cold nights of Procureland, and also the threat from the big bad wolf. So he thought and planned, and planned and thought, and even consulted the other wise men from Procureland to procure the shelter that had all the necessary functions to keep him warm, cozy, and safe. The outcome of the procurement was indeed novel. It had super insulating foam concrete walls with solar panels and a high-tech anti-wolf laser system at the perimeter. The third little procurer saw that the hard work paid off, and it made him very happy. One cold night, the big bad wolf, who dearly loved to eat tasty little procurers, came along and saw the first little procurer in his shelter of straw. He said, let me in, little procurer, or I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in."
"Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin,"
said the little procurer. But of course, the wolf did blow the shelter in, and luckily, the first little procurer had a chance to flee to the shelter of the second little procurer. The wolf then came to the shelter made of sticks. "Let me in, little procurer, or I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in."
"Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin,"
said the two little procurers together. But the wolf blew and blew, and finally managed to blow that shelter in too. Luckily, again the two little procurers had a chance to escape to the shelter of the third little procurer. The wolf then came to the house of the third little procurer. "Let me in, cried the wolf, "or I'll huff and I'll puff till I blow your house in."
"Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin,"
said the three little procurers together. Little did the big bad wolf know that the response time of the anti-wolf laser system was 0.1 microseconds. The laser turret started shooting at the big bad wolf. The wolf immediately started feeling the heat and ran away. The three little procurers realized that this was the end of their troubles with the big bad wolf. The next day, the little procurers invited their mother over. She said,
"You see, it is just as I told you. The way to get along in the world is to do things as best you can."
Fortunately for all three little procurers, they learned that lesson, and they lived happily ever after.